Alright, it's a late night video. Sorry guys, I was pretty busy. I had, I got set up with the government to have my students, and I have 12 now. I got to get one private student to his license, or to hers. And so there's a little bit delay, so I make maybe a short video tomorrow where I just maybe talk or show some things. The quick one I wanted to do tonight is my basilisk is 21st March 2018. I think at least that is it. It doesn't tell me the version number here. What the heck? However, I had an update, and then my LastPass, I'm using LastPass for my password stuff and things like that, and it didn't work. Incompatible with the latest version of Basilisk. So if you let it update, you have LastPass running or some other extensions which are incompatible, then you are screwed. So what I did, I went into Tools, Preference, Advanced, Update, and I switched it to Never Check for Updates. Not recommended, but what can you do? I mean, for me, it's never a big deal. By the way, that's what I really, really do not like. I think maybe it's still there. Let's see if I can. Yes, I can. Because every time when I boot back into that Peppermint OS, I have to put on this key ring password in order to get to my network shares. So, but I mean, for me, I've got my Nobody's Home, right? But that is on the not on my partition here. That is on my network access storage. And here I've got my apps, and here's Basilisk. So I just copy that, copy, paste. You know, copy, go back to my home, go into my apps, and paste. And then here it is. The only thing I then have to do is, of course, go right-click, say Property, Permission, Allow Executing. And I do it for the bin too, just in case. I mean, I fire up the script, but doesn't matter. So, yeah. So, phew. You will give me the crap for telling you not to do updates, right? But for me, it's an easy question. I need my LastPass because I've got tons of passwords which I can't remember. They are a nightmare. For most of my things, I've got two-way authentication, and I can only recommend it. Two-way authentication is the way to go. And I use Authy. It's Authy. And that runs on Android, iOS, and all the other stuff, whatever. So, and I use that for two-way authentication, and it's a great tool. And what that allows you, you can have a totally easy, simple password, and everybody can look over your shoulder, but with two-way authentication, after 30 seconds, it's all gone. So you need to have the two-way authentication. And I got it on my super old iPad, the big one, you know. Apple let it run out, of course, because they say I have to buy a new one, they want my money, and I say no. So I've got a Nexus 7 tablet, I've got my Android Asus phone here, and they all have Authy on it. So, and that's my two-way authentication. Authy, that is this one, what I use. And that synchronizes with all other... Would that work here too? Oh yeah, you can get it here too. Google Play, oh yeah, here it is. How does it look like? Can they not give me a picture? Oh, Windows, oh. However, that's a symbol. It's red, usually. And it works fine for me, I must say. So it's a good thing. Yeah, for now, I have to jump one update. I'd have to see if LastPass is updating something, or if... Basilisk next update is taking care of the extension. On the other hand, you can see I always have my Chromium here, so I like Chromium. I don't know if I have that here, because here I'm not doing too much usual. Here I play games, and I just did. Yeah, here I don't have Google Chrome installed. On my Calculate Linux, I've got Chromium, Google Chrome, and Google Chrome I use for my music library to upload stuff. With Chromium I had trouble. Google Chrome works fine with Google services, so I only use it for Google services. Job done. Everything else I use Basilisk. If they give me trouble with my extension, then I have to roll back to my Chromium browser, which I use every now and then, right? I use it in a moment more on my Antique 17 install on my Packard Bell laptop, which is pretty cool. And yeah, here's again, you know, people say, oh, no, could say, no, they don't say, because I'm not writing it so much that I'm calculate Linux fan, I might do. However, why I'm always so on calculate Linux is it's pretty easy. I had to print something. So, no, my wife, oh, yeah, here, my wife was here on the weekend, so danger zone, right? So she said, can you scan this for me? So and I went on Antiques. Oh, here it goes. Antiques is usual. I liked it, and I still like it. I mean, I play around with Fluxbox or Fluxbox, and it's pretty neat. That's the IS3 for lazy people. And I couldn't scan for what reason soever. I mean, to the defense, most likely because I changed, I rebooted my router. And I think usually I got static IPs for my printer and my NAS station and stuff like that. And for some reason, I did a system update, a software update on my router. And after that, I couldn't print anymore. So, scan. But on the other hand, so then I went down because I was in danger zone, right? Wife says, can you scan it? I said, yes, and I could not from my Packard Bell laptop with Antiques on it. So I run down back to my gaming laptop. Of course, I had Calculate Linux on, and I could scan. So, saved the day. And these little experiences I had quite often, where I had that, yeah, was with a printer before too. I couldn't print with any other thing, with Ubuntu or whatever it was. And Calculate Linux always just did the job, and that makes it so reliable to me. And yeah, it's just what it is. It is a very nice, great operating system. And I hope that I make quite some money soon here, that I can get some other hardware. I'm using my gaming laptop, but I have to play here with Peppermint OS, but that's not really my daily driver. And I would love to use my Calculate Linux for this. So I'm thinking and hoping that I could get my, maybe a little PC with a good NVIDIA graphic card on, or AMD. And then, could have my Calculate Linux, and I don't have to boot anymore in any other operating system just to play my games or things like that, right? So, having said this, I'm not there yet. And I won't be before fall. Sorry, guys, I'm so tired. I was yesterday, this morning, 2 o'clock, I arrived at home after 630 kilometers. It was terrible late. I was super tired. I had to stand up kind of early, get the portal set up and things like that, and call around, arrange to see my students, and so I can get the schedule done. So I was a little bit busy. And yeah, sorry guys, I mean, usually I put a video up, I put a few videos up, people are not so interested in Antiques, I can say, which is kind of a shame, you know. Antiques and Fluxbox, it is neat. I have it on a dining table, my wife can't see it, haha, so and I got it on my dining table, and I run it from there. And yeah, what I did is on Antiques, then once my wife was gone back to her place, I just uninstalled and reinstalled the printer, and that fixed the problem again. And job done. So Antiques can now print and scan again. I think it had screwed up my router, screwed it up when I updated the firmware. So now I know in the future. I mean, usually I have a text file with all my MAC addresses, and so that I can give static IP addresses to my devices. And that's what I do. Usually I get static IPs. And that was it. Yeah, I just figured that out, that people might be taken by surprise here. Because usual Basilisk is updating itself. You boot back and then all of a sudden, brain, you can't access your LastPass anymore. Danger zone. So, not a big deal. Not a big problem. I just froze it for now. Sergio is giving me the crap for it, I trust. Oh, yeah, and he said I have to try Falcon, and I will. So There's another video coming up soon. I will do one tomorrow, even though I've got tons of stuff to do. Fair play, wargaming. Oxymoron. It's not possible. It's wargaming. How can there be fair play? It's a rigged game. It's cheating, lying, and deceiving. That's what's going on there. However, good we talked about it. But here, people checked that. Serious info, encrypted, decrypt. Yeah, because maybe because of the FreeNAS extras, which is coming soon. I fired it up. I just had a quick look. I still have the old interface, which is great. And both are working fine. So my TARDIS, which is now the Voyager, and my Centurion is still the Centurion. So and I fire that up and I show it. And yeah, but I can't do it tonight, guys. It's again 22:34. So time for Sandman to come around and do his job so that I can sleep nicely. And tomorrow, tomorrow I'll make a small video. But I have lots of typing to do, but not a problem. I will just cut off my typical 5 minutes videos and upload it. So I hope that helps somebody. Everybody says, oh, not recommended, not recommended. That's what it is. Not recommended for me to not have my LastPass because that causes trouble. And yeah, Dragonfly, I'm still interested in getting that working. I'm just not familiar with the Hammer 2 file system, stuff like that. And if I would need it like that, right? Yeah, Oracle. And Triskel, yeah, that's most likely time travel. I wish I could use it. That would be really neat, but I'm playing games, so I need it working. So, nevertheless, I had one troll on my website, on my channel, saying, don't watch this, this guy has no clue. Yeah, he picked one video out where I ranted, or did my rant about something. So he doesn't know the whole story, right? In many of these videos I explain why I rant, how it comes that I rant, why do I approach it like this. Because, yeah, for the new subscribers, I approach every distro, everything I fire up like a noob, a newbie. And often I might be one, right? So I just go there, happy booting up, checking out, finding troubles. And usually I go with blazing guns to the forums to see how the community acts or reacts. And then all is good. Then I know. And this is it. That's how I go with all these little things. And then when I find... or if I find some little things which I can fix, I fix it, make some tutorials, and if it helps somebody, if it just helps one person, job well done. And on the other hand, I use these programs or these OSs in order to test them, right? If I don't fire them up, if I don't use them at least a few times in a week, then I can't give my statement. How would I know? VirtualBox is good for showing stuff, but it doesn't show you how an operating system works on real hardware. And most of the time people don't really install much on VirtualBox either. Like for me, it's my printer scanner, that's a must have. Then I got my Synology disk station stuff. Why is it not showing up here? Yeah, that's weird. But I think I have it installed. At least in, here, Synology drive. At least I have it running on my Calculate Linux, of course. Yeah, here it is too. So, all right, so it's here, it's just not showing. It doesn't show my Calculate Linux either, but this is Ubuntu-based, and it has a .deb file, and it should show up, it just doesn't. But not a deal-breaker. I'm Peppermint OS is doing a good job playing my games. It doesn't give me the glitches like Xubuntu did, or Linux Mint did. I know this might hurt, but it's a bit sluggish, you see. The second you get an unpopulated file manager, and then it happens. And that happens even if I don't have any network shares on. And I don't have network shares on. See? It's a little bit weird, that delay. So it's by no means as fast as Calculate Linux, or better saying Gentoo, maybe. It just goes, bam, it's there, right on. So... and that spoils you, these even with copying, pasting, moving stuff around. As I said, Calculate Linux, from my experience, has the best multitasking I've ever seen. I can't say it from Gentoo because I haven't done a Gentoo install. I still owe it somebody. And I will do it. I've got to do it. Most likely in the summertime when I got more time. My big batch I have to train is from now for 2 months. July, August. These 2 months is when I got tons of time. All right, guys. This is it. Just a small, tiny little video about Basilisk and how to prevent it from updating into something which renders it useless for you. If you use LastPass, the next update will just kill it. And for me, that means, I mean, for me, it's never a big deal because I have copies on my network access storage. I think I got it in the Dirk folder. Here's Basilisk. Then if I go back, I got it in my Nobody's Home in apps. Here's my Basilisk. So I just have many copies. And it's not a big file. And you can keep the tar file or whatever it is, a small one. However, this is it, guys. I hope that video helps one person, then job well done. Otherwise, it was a little bit entertaining and updating what's going on. I didn't say much because there wasn't much going on. I was just terrible busy, hit the road, and when I'm on the road, I can't do much on videos. Okay. Yeah, so this is it, guys. I wish you all a happy good night. And what is it, Tuesday? Tomorrow's Wednesday. Yeah, so there's still some videos coming up. And I hope you enjoyed, like it. I don't know if the troll is coming back. I hope it's not. He's not that a troll, kind of, I think, at least. He might have just been hurt that I said something negative for his favorite operating system. But so I didn't block him, of course. Why would I? It's still a free country, right? Or a free world. It should be a free world. I almost got carried away about the Toronto incident, which we had in England, in France, and everywhere. So yeah, it's easy to guess, right, what's going on there. And however, I'm not getting carried away now. Okay, guys, have a good night, and I will make a video tomorrow. Yeah, I will make one. I have a good idea of what I'm going to do. Okay, guys, have a good night, and speak to you soon. Bye-bye, bye, 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 bye.